So, well, I guess we should pick.
Are you gradually changing the stone over so that we don't accidentally tilt it?
That is correct. And it's easier to do now because, you know, we have a bunch of stone I can use.
All right, so we should use, what, dirt blocks to expand out for the monster and animal areas?
Well, you can use cobblestone or some stone variant.
Uh-huh.
But you will need dirt for the animals to spawn on.
All right, so I'll put the pickaxe back in the chest for now.
Wait, I was like, wait a second, I need the pickaxe.
Yeah.
Still, because I'm working on it. What am I doing?
So I will work on expanding out in my direction for monsters. Seth, do you want to expand out by the buckets of the farm out in the opposite direction for the animals?
Okay.
Because that's kind of farmish area, so I figure that direction's good for the animals.
Keep everything very well lit while you're working, even in the place where you want to eventually have monsters. Because you may notice that there is literally nowhere for monsters to spawn right now. So every monster that will spawn in the area that monsters can spawn.
Okay. So
lots of monsters very quickly.
First thing I'm going to do is I'm going to...
You should make the monster spawner below us.
Well, it needs to be far away because if it's too close, they can't spawn.
Right.
But yes, but then I can harass him about, you know, figuring out the trick to building a floor below.
Oh, yeah, there is that too.
Yeah. So, first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to knock out three of this fence so I have room to work. Got that, good. Now, just in case, I'm going to put important stuff away, including this fence. No, the fence is good to have. Is that a gate? Actually, a gate would be a good idea. Alright, so first, I need to expand out, so I need... dirt. Oh, I hate doing these. There we go.
Just hold shift. Like they said, you can't follow.
I am still scared.
Honestly, what I would do is to get away from us, I would use wood.
I would use cobblestone.
Because we have infinity.
Fine.
I just gave you 16 cobblestone.
Okay. You did?
Oh. Well, it's on the floor behind
you. It's on the ground.
All right, so I'll get rid of this.
I mean, you are welcome to use whatever materials you want. I'm not here to judge or anything like that, but if you want to expand a very long way very quickly, cobblestone is definitely your best friend.
All right, so cobblestone. All right. I am...
Just because you can get infinity of it?
Uh-huh. And you can get it very quickly. I mean, we can get infinite dirt, too.
Because we have the generator now. Yeah, got it. All right. All right. But first, let's go one more.
I like that when someone crouches, their name disappears off of the mini-map, so I can tell when mod is twerking.
All right.
I'm doing the dance of the leaves.
There we go. I put up a gate. So, I'm still unsure how to build down, but I need to build out anyway, so.
Can I tell him?
It's up to you.
He's not going to figure it out.
Nope, I'm done.
He hasn't played Minecraft that much.
Uh-huh. I'm a dub.
Can I just well, tell
you, go on ahead.
So, you know how water goes down?
Yeah. Oh, it's...
You can take a waterfall down and you can swim up a waterfall.
Oh. I've done. Yep, so I have swum up waterfalls before. I just had never thought of it for use it for construction purposes.
Yeah.
I didn't until he said gravity, and I was like, oh, geez.
Yep. So you ride the waterfall down, put some blocks underneath where you want to build, then swim back up, and then you can build off of where you built down to.
All right. So.
But you have to be careful.
Yep. It is.
You can jump out of the waterfall or something.
Mm-hmm. It is not undangerous.
Oh, God.
That's the name of my new band, Not Undangerous.
I don't like that at all.
Oh, yeah, if you're going to do it, you definitely want to put all your stuff in the chest.
Ooh, we need
so,
a torch.
Essentially, my idea was not too far off.
Committing seppuku?
Yeah, the whole jumping off and putting the blocks underneath. It's just I didn't have
this is a chance for survival.
Yeah.
Yeah, you'll get back up from this one.
Alright, well, I am currently 4 out. I mean, I have enough problem doing what I'm currently doing. I mean, this is seriously not...
problem in general, we know.
This is seriously not okay, guys.
Skyblock for the guy with acrophobia.
Yeah.
Aw, yeah.
5 out right now.
Wait, how does that transfer over to a video game?
Apparently it really does.
It does.
Like, it's super common.
Like, I don't even need VR for it.
I mean, I can totally see it, but then again, I have a degree. It's just, it seems funny.
Uh-huh.
For you. Not so much for me.
Don't worry, my degree says that your logic is not unfounded.
So, Rav, if you ever end up visiting and using my Vive, I will have you play Richie's Plank Experience.
Oh, I know you will. I know you will. You know, when I am also one of those people who I... 4, 5, 6, 7...
Wait, does that mean you can't take...
Go ahead.
Does that mean you can't take planes?
Oh, no, planes are fun.
Because you're enclosed?
Yeah. Oh, I need more.
You've got a lot of... And planes and everything that can go wrong with them.
Oh, no, I'm perfectly fine with planes. No issues whatsoever.
You've never seen all the things that can go wrong.
So what we do is we let the monster spawn, we stand on the side and watch them fall off and wave?
Well, I mean, you could do that, but you wouldn't get any loot for it.
Yeah, right now I'm...
You'd let them come up to the fence and then shoot them, or right. Hit them.
Yeah, you'll want to... The idea is that you create a place where monsters will spawn but can't hurt you.
Yep.
And then you just stab them.
Kind of like the monster farm spawner thing that Seth made?
Yep, almost exactly. Except that you need to just make a dark room instead of use a spawner. In fact, I think that design would work really well here. So
it would actually work really well here.
Yeah, just make a dark room and have the same thing happen. So, Seth,
build up.
We've assigned it to you.
I will I'm going to expand out.
That will take
out.
A very, very, very long time to do what I did. It took like the entire stream.
Well, do something similar anyway.
Well, I'm at least going to make our dark room, so.
The easiest thing you could do, which would be fine for most mobs, creepers might be bad, and skeletons sometimes can shoot, is you make it a floor above. Uh-huh. So that you see their feet, you can stab them in their feet. You still can get, the drops and stuff that go there. And you can put water buckets in the back so everybody's forced to go to the front.
Uh-huh.
That's a temporary fix that would be a lot easier to do than the actual monster spawner that I was doing. Mainly because the monster spawner that I'm doing has to go... What is it? It's like a 9x9 square that you hollow out where the monster spawner would be. And then you take water to flush them out to the front. And then they go up. What is it? Was it 16 spots? So 30. It goes up 32, and then it comes out. 7, 14.
You know,
comes out 16, and then they drop down so that they can take the damage.
You can just have them spawn 16 up, because you can control where they spawn here.
Yeah. Well, I mean, yeah, for the monster spawner thing wouldn't work, because that's the most efficient, because you have a monster spawner. But yeah, we could do the same thing. We could go ahead and take them. I think it's actually more than 16 blocks. I think it's... See, I think the fall is more than 16. It's 16 up, and then you go down because you have stuff that you can dig into. I think it's like 20-something down, 18-something. I forget how many they fall, but you let them fall. That way you're using less swings with your sword.
Uh-huh.
You can sword once and kill them, or punch them like 2 to 3 times and kill them.
Yep, you've got this all figured out.
Yep.
Just remember that since there's nowhere for monsters to spawn, just having a dark room is more effective than an actual monster spawner. Like, they will spawn that quickly. Yeah. Because Minecraft will be like, okay, I want to spawn a monster, let's find a spot for it. Oh, well, there's a spot. Spawn one there. And then it will do the same thing over and over again.
Server backup started. Done in 72 milliseconds.
Took too much time, man. You got to build a bigger machine.
All right, I'll work on it.
All right, so let's put... Let's grab those. I'm going to make a new bucket. Oh, I need to actually grab the clay. There we go. Bucket.
What are you bucketing up?
We don't have a bucket anymore, so I figure I should make a bucket.
Oh, okay.
We are out of room in the chest.
Make another chest. We've got plenty of wood.
We also have plenty of axes inside the chest.
I know. It was an accident. I've been working on it. I'm down to 4 in my inventory, okay?
I took the stone out so I could make the bucket. There's fire on this.
Oh yeah. That'll happen sometimes.
Okay. It's burning the fence.
I thought fences couldn't actually burn down. I guess that changed. Fine, I'll replace these with wooden or with stone walls now that we can.
All right, well,
cobblestone fence, why not?
Yeah. Friggin' mechanics changing between 1.7 and 1.10.
There you go. Here's some of the stone that was in the furnace.
Where'd it go?
I need cobblestone.
Did you pick it up? Did you pick up some slabs, Zen?
Negative.
Let's see.
You need more cobblestone, right, Rev?
Yeah.
Here you go.
Thank you.
I'm just working the cobble mines.
Do stuff in the the crafting stations, do they actually go into the chest if you don't pick them up?
It was lucky.
They stay on the crafting station, actually.
That's a while ago. I missed somebody in chat.
That's the other nice thing about the Tinker's Construct crafting station is that it doesn't throw everything on the floor if you close it. It just stays there.
True. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. I hate this so much.
I've created a second chest, and I'm going to make it the dirt chest.
Alright.
Dirt and wood.
Alright.
So that way...
I am 10 away now.
Since you're doing animals, you will want, eventually, when you get there and all, to make a, it'll be a grass field that is well lit.
All right, well, this is the...
No, Rab's doing the monster spawner. We're going to do the farm on the other side. What's the maximum area they spawn in again? 16 by 16?
Yeah, I thought Rab was doing the farm.
Nope, monsters.
No, Rab's doing the monsters.
Shows what I know.
Except that I'll probably help him with the monster room. To be able to do the waters that do the fall down, and I got to figure out how many blocks it is they fall before they hit, so we can hit a half slab and they don't come out and kill us.
Mm-hmm.
But at least he's starting the platform out there so that I can watch him die, not me.
Yeah, I'm doing the distance part. So if you want the down stuff, what are you guys going to have to do that?
Well, you can really build up to get the monsters to fall.
Well, yeah, but the achievement for the down.
Oh, yeah, well.
All right. Any more cobblestone?
You're excited at all if you don't do it.
You're just tempting me and saying to try to get me to do it.
Just make sure you build a chest and put your stuff in it.
In fact, I actually might want to make a chest to begin with, so.
I mean, if you build the four blocks up above it so you can put the water in it so that it goes up and down straight, you're not going to have any water pushing you any specific direction. So as long as you don't use the WADS keys, you could just use your space bar to go up and down.
Yeah. But I'll still be terrified.
Okay, we do not have the stuff that I can use to automate this yet. Boo.
So,
oh, they have something that'll like actually crush it for you?
Yep, it will take the blocks and just stick them in an inventory, but we need like lapis and redstone and some other stuff.
I put this little chest here for my personal stuff, so that way in case I die, they'll all be there. Only carry what I need on me.
Yeah, if you lose the achievement book, is there a way to remake it, or do you just go, goodbye?
It is two purple dyes in a book. Now that I think about it, though, why don't I make a achievement book stand that we can all use in case you lose your book?
Okay.
Oh, is it like a stand that you can use and everybody can go over and click it so we can all see that where we're at?
Yep. I don't remember if it gives you your individual achievements.
Or if it's a server-based.
Yeah, I don't remember, but I guess it doesn't matter, really. Is there no wood left?
The second chest.
Other chest.
Ah, okay.
Though I imagine we should keep the wood in this chest and put, like, seeds and stuff in this other chest, stuff that we're not going to be using for crafting.
You could build a chest over here by where I've got the farm.
Seed.
You can never have enough chests.
Let's see. Seeds. I'm grabbing all the seeds right now.
Achievement stand. Okay, so it looks like an enchanting table, but it's not.
It has... Oh, well, wait a minute. We're all at the same clicks. I'm going to click make a dark room 25 away. Can you see it?
Nope.
Okay, so it's individual then.
Okay. So yeah, feel free to use this achievement stand.
All right. Good, good, good.
Strangely looks like an enchanting table. I don't know why.
Weird, huh?
Crow!
So the way I'm figuring it, that Forge actually adds blocks to Minecraft.
Oh, yeah. It adds lots and lots of stuff, which is why you need to...
Yeah, you need to be able to load the stuff up because they're going to add, like, you won't have enough blocks in the original Minecraft world to retexture them.
Uh-huh.
You'd actually have to add stuff.
Right. Which is why you need to download it on your client as well as on the server.
All right. Stuff that aren't used for crafting.
Well, I've made our cobblestone generator sufficiently dramatic.
Bum, bum, bum.
And I'll just work on the friggin' cobblestone mines.
But still, technically, underneath there's the cobblestone. So if we accidentally tilted and hit, it would drop the...
Wait, did I
miss lava block? Would be fine.
Did I miss blocks down there?
Did you take them out underneath the lava?
Yeah.
Oh, okay, I didn't see.
I mean, I might have missed a block or two, but we should be good.
Well... Worst case scenario, you hit it, it breaks, and you go, oh, and put a new block in there.
Uh-huh.
well, eventually we'll make like the watermelon farm. So we, well, actually, there's probably better food that we can make and have it automated, right?
Yep.
All right, then I could put those.
Oh, my pickaxe, my plickaxe, is almost broken. So, I should start. Well, I could use a hammer on it to get gravel, so I can just sift that. Yeah. What am I doing?
I'm putting tools into this chest in the corner, since really we don't need it.
I'm stealing both of these hammers.
All right.
There's some cobblestone in the main chest if you want to use that to keep building. And that's all the cobblestone for now, because I'm going to be making a bunch of gravel to sift so I can repair my pickaxe.
Is it more efficient to repair than replace?
Yes, and in fact, here, let me break my pickaxe. Where you at? Check this out.
Checking.
Broken. Got broken. It. So they never actually destroy.
Yep.
They just,
yep, they become broken and useless, but then you can repair them, which is an advantage of Tinker's Construct. Here you go, Rav, if you want to see. That's what happens when a Tinker's Construct tool breaks.
Oh, nice. Then what I'll do is I'll put
it basically makes it so nothing ever breaks and poofs. It just is unusable.
Right.
All right, so I have our tools in this chest in the corner here. Crafting supplies will be the ones, or stuff that we can craft, will be this middle one here. Like plants and stuff for this one.
Do mind that the tools don't go poof only applies to the Tinker's Construct ones.
So vanilla tools go poof.
I'm putting my food in the plant chest.
Also, hammers go poof, which you are probably all aware of by now.
Yeah. All right, I need more cobblestone.
Well, there's some in the chest, and once I get some flint, I'll be able to start making more again, but... Yeah, right. You know, you can't get cobblestone from a cobblestone block without a pickaxe.
There we go, that should be enough of that. All right. You know what? My achievement book is going in the... my extra books and whatnot are going in the tool chest. That way, I am carrying the bare minimum. Alright.
Oh, so animals spawn the same way that mobs do.
Yep, except it has to be on grass, I believe. I don't think dirt
works. Grass. You can't do it on cobblestone.
Yeah, and it has to be... Did I just hear a zombie? I don't see a zombie on my mini-map. I must be going insane. 10,
11, 12, 13, 14. Out now.
I imagine it would also have to be night.
Yeah.
Well, not necessarily. If someone blocked off something from daylight, could have spawned a zombie, which is how the monster room's going to work.
All right. So we are currently 15 out on this side. I think we are doing rather well.
We're moving right along.
Need to repair the pickaxe?
Yep. And to repair Tinker's Construct stuff, you can go back to the tool station.
Uh-huh.
You just stick it in the center and then stick the repair material in, and that's it.
So in this case,
it doesn't even cost experience points.
So it's just you put in the flint because that's the headpiece that broke.
That's right. You got it.
So pretty much for that now, we just need one flint and one or two flint just to fix that.
That's right.
Just one?
Just one. Well, it won't fix it 100%, but... you get a significant amount of repair from it.
All right. We are closing in on the 3-hour mark.
Indeed we are.
All right. Good, good, good.
And here is some more cobblestone.
All right.
So watermelon with something else can be turned into water in the vat. Hooch? Oh, is that
hooch?
Is it alcohol?
Yeah.
All right, so this will put us 20 away.
What am I doing?
Flinting stuff.
I am going to make a couple new sieves that have a flint stiffened mesh, which gets us some different stuff out of it.
Okay.
Like the lapis lazuli, which I need to make the automation for the friggin' cobblestone generator. That's what I was trying to say.
All right, I did not grab torches, which I need.
Why you gotta be like that?
All right.
Flint stiffened mesh.
All right, almost got 21 out. It's fence gate.
See, now flint stiffened mesh for the gravel gets you coal and lapis instead of flint, which is why you still want to have the string one as well if you need more flint.
Right.
How do you find that out? Just by looking at the, like, doing flint whatever and it'll tell you?
Yep. If you find the flint stiffened mesh in JEI and hit U, it will tell you what you can get.
Hi, Connor. Thanks for watching. So, right now, the path goes 21 out. We're pretty close to the... Or does, is it supposed to be... I guess it's up to our own judgment, isn't it?
Yep.
But it's definitely more than 25 from our center, but not so much our base proper.
Essentially, what it means is, if there's a player within 25, no monsters will spawn.
Right.
In the block that someone's close to.
And so, yeah. We're 21 away from the fence. I need it.
And that should be fine, especially if you build more than just one line of monster spawning area.
Yeah. But I'm going to do the 25 because reasons.
Hey, whatever you want to do.
Yep, so let's just to be lazy here. All right. Need wood planks.
That 25 blocks only matters if it's darkness, though. If it's not darkness, though, right?
No, it has to be dark.
Oh, I just noticed that you don't need to switch them to planks first before you can make them into sticks. You can actually go to straight wood.
I did not know that.
Yeah, I just found that out.
Yeah, if you're closer than 25, even if it's dark, monsters will not spawn. Which is how we didn't die the first couple nights.
He's got a spear? What? German? I don't know. I had somebody talking my channel. It looks like he's gone. So it doesn't make a difference.
Grab torches just to be safe. Because it would help if I actually divided these in half first. Oh well.
If you want another way to make a room, Rav, a tree is a handy way to get high fast.
Smoking tree leaves, huh?
It just so happens to get on top of the tree. You know, shenanigans.
Working all day in the cobblestone mine.
There we go.
And that's the pickaxe again.
All right, and that is 3 hours.
All right.
So I think...
Here's a stack of cobblestone.
Okay. Which I will use next time. It's a good time to end the stream. I have other stuff I need to do today. So, everybody, thanks for watching. Hope you guys like the new setup, since it's not the traditional Minecraft, but I think it's more, you know, less boring of us just digging in the mines. Anyway, thanks for watching. Don't forget to like, subscribe, favorite, do whatever you need to on your platform, and we will catch you guys next time. Later.
See you later.